Hello, welcome to Scrap Time episode 855. My name is Christine, and on today's episode, we have a demo featuring Tracy Bautista.
Hi, I'm Tracy Bautista, and I'm coming to you live from the Sakura booth at CHA in Anaheim, and I'm going to be sharing with you some of my favorite Sakura products and how I use them with my new mixed media stamp line, too. And it's called Graffiti Glam. So I'm gonna take you through some fun layers on how I layer their watercolor paints with some of my favorite markers and pens. Okay, so for this one, this is the Koi Travel watercolor set. And I'm just laying down color. When I paint, this is exactly how I paint with any kind of paint, acrylic, watercolor. I just like to create backgrounds with it. The fun thing about the water brush is that it's a little less messy when you're painting because all the water is contained in the brush. So you don't have to get out extra supplies. It's great for traveling. It's like one of my favorites. I use this on the airplane all the time. People are always like walking by the aisles and like, what are you doing? So I'm just laying down a little color with the paint. And the more pressure you put on the handle of the brush, the more water you'll get when you're painting. So the more transparent your paint will be. And you can clean off the brush on a towel just by squeezing it if you want to change the color. And then I can go back in and use more color and then make darker lines if I don't want as much water in there. And then one of the other things I love to do also is mix in the pens. Let's see what we'll do. So if you want even more of a finer line and writing, you can use the pens. And these are water-based also, so it's okay if they end up getting wet because you can actually mix them with and paint them out so then they become a little bit more watercolor. Look, you get the watercolor look.
Yeah, like something for a small Sakura section. They have all their, the ones that they put in, they don't put Sakura. No, the very bottom.
I'm going to do this over it while it's wet. This is the Jelly Roll White pen. So you can use it, I use it both wet and dry. You kind of have to clean it off if you want little details in your paint to add a little bit of white. And then I'm going to do it on the white and let this dry because this will become a nice resist. And so when I'm working in my journal, this is pretty similar to the way I work. I work really fast and I just like to play. It's all about experimenting. And then I'm going to do a couple of things with these stamps. Get a little bit more water. Hello. So I'm using the little sponge that comes with the watercolor set to mix my color.
Yeah,
I forgot my big sponge, so this is actually a nice little substitute. So when I paint with my stamps, I'm usually using some kind of sponge application. And you keep in mind, this paint is a watercolor, so it's going to be a lot more transparent and give kind of that watercolor look. And what I like to do actually is use a brayer, but since I don't have one, I'm using this is my curling iron cover. anything to rub down the paint works great. You could use like even the top of this, or you could put it on an acrylic sheet and do that. I'm always using my stamps kind of random places, so I'm going to put it down. And see, the great thing about using them is that this particular stamp application is going to give you kind of that messy look. And all the stamps are meant to be used in layers. So I'm going to just keep layering it. And depending on how you apply the paint and the type of colors you're using, will give you different prints, and depending on like the amount of pressure. So I'm just gonna keep layering. I'll do one with just my finger so you can kind of see the difference. So a little bit more watercolor effect. And that's kind of the look I'm going for, because what I do is I love to take pieces and just keep layering so I've got these fun backgrounds, and then I can doodle and draw over them. And when I'm working, I'm usually working on multiple pieces at once. So I'm gonna do a little bit more on here, and then I'll come onto this one and do a little bit more painting or drawing with the markers over the other one. So I'll add a little bit more paint. And just keep layering. I'm wanting that little just hint of color when I'm working on my journal pages. And a lot of times I'll just use even corners of my stamps too, to print just a piece of it onto the page. And then I'm gonna let this dry and show you some other fun ways to use the markers, and then come back over this later with more pens. So it's always about working in layers. It keeps you kind of fresh, it keeps you experimenting, and then it allows you to let pieces dry so that you don't get like those muddied backgrounds. So I want to show you how the pens work over. This is acrylic paint. Everything on here is acrylic, and you can see some of my stamps on here. They're all different layers, and this is all dry already. So whenever I'm working in a page, you know, I'll section off areas just from what I see, you know, that I've done previously. So a lot of times when I work in my journals, I have pages that are like this that are just pieces, and then I'll come back to them at a later date to continue to work on them. The great thing about the Koi marker brush markers is that they blend, so you can do a lot of fun kind of blending effects over the paint. And then you can also come back in with the water brush too and spread this color out. I can go back over some of the stamp marks that I made earlier with the pens. See how it adds just that little hint of extra color on there. So those are the coloring brush pens, and then now I'm going to take some of the Jelly Roll glaze and use these over the top. So these are one of my favorites, kind of as that final layer when you're working, because it takes a little bit of time to dry. And it dries, has like a little raised effect, so you can do a lot more fine details and doodling with these. So in a few minutes you'll see they have a shininess to them when they dry. I found that these work best when the paint underneath, if it's acrylic, that it's dry. And then everybody's always looking for a fun white pen to use. And the Jelly Roll White, this one is one of my favorites to do fine line writing with on my journals. So you'll notice when I work with these, I'm doing like smaller areas, because it's such a smaller pen nib size. So for this one, I think I'll let this one dry for a little bit, and then I'll go back to that first one that I started on. And you kind of see what I do with these. So, let's see. I think I have decided I'm going to draw a face over this one. So I'm painting out just a little area where I want to start drawing her face, and this will kind of give me a guide. When I paint, I actually tend to, you'll notice, I tend to blend the colors right on the paper when I'm working. And then, let's see, maybe I'll give her some pink hair. That's kind of red. So I always like to kind of start with my outline for the faces. And then I'll go in with detail with the pens and draw more. And start to draw one of my girly faces. Give her a little lipstick.
All right.
her little headdress.
Occasionally we might have some, you know, we're just continuing something or whatever. It's not too often, but if something comes up.
So whenever you're working with these pens, it's always best to just have fun and experiment. That's really what your art journal is for. And not worry if you feel like you made a mistake. You can always doodle over it even more to change it. Dry a little bit more. So I'll let her dry for a little bit.
Well, that's it for today's episode. Be sure to check out our website at www.scraptime.ca. And on our next episode, I am showing you my latest Disney album featuring the Studio Calico Handbook products. So please join us. Thanks for watching Scrap Time.